first one is keep the equation of course. And then, So, passing 3. So, passing 3, we have this one. This is a wave equation. So, we ask you to solve this one by using this boundary condition. So, the boundary condition is u dirt e. X zero, the boundary condition, right? Zero means that A plus solve this instrument equation. And then, so you solve it, right? And after from here, if you have an A e to the power of this pi minus A e to the power minus this pi, and then reach you zero. So this means that the A is, so you have this one minus this one. So zero. So since this term itself is not equal to zero, then you get the A equal to zero, right? So A is zero, it sucks you in, is B equals minus A, and zero. So from here, again you get the X equal to zero, then you get U equal to zero, right? So we just ignore that. It'll be right. So just ignore this. And then, next one is the third one. So you don't have this one. And k is smaller than 2. So for k smaller than 2, just like k b minus e, right? So it's e result. And then you have x double prime between by kx, and then it's minus e squared x, right? So for this, the general rule is given by k cosine px plus B sine Px, right? The general solution. Okay? So now, and then x 0 is 0. So this means that your A plus B times 0, so it's 0. It means that B is 0, right? And then after that, have x L 0, which means that since your B is already 0, it means that A cosine B pi. So we have a cosine p I, which is 0. Pi 0. So this means that sine and x. 19x. So that's it, right? And okay. So now we substitute in the initial condition. So u x 0, u x 0 is given by k sine x minus sine 2x. Right? And then this equals, so from here, when t is 0, t is 0, so you get n from 1 to infinity. So you have a cn, here this is the 1, right? And sine nx. Right, that's it. It's now in the part of cn. So cn is, if you can integrate, if you want, just integrate. If you don't want, if you already know from here, right, just pick up. Because obviously, n cannot be 1 to 2. Otherwise, this same index is going to be equal to 2, right? It's okay, right? If you don't want, just integrate. You integrate from, you multiply this one by sine x on both sides, integrate. And then you can get this one. After that, minus by sine 2, you integrate. And then after that, minus sine m. So anyway, if m is not equal to 1 and 2, you'll get 0 anyway, right? So, but you don't need to do that. Just compare this one. You just pick up and do the c1. So what is c1? It's k. Right? This is m k. And then c2 is minus k. And then n is 0 if n is not equal to 1 or 2. Right? So that's okay. It's okay. No? It's okay, right? Because if you look at this, in this one, you just expand it. You get C1 sine x plus C2 sine 2x, then plus C3 sine 3x, right? So that's why, so if you, the most probably do it is just multiply by sine mx from both sides integrate. And then you find out that if m is not equal to 1 or 2, then c must be 0, right? So once you know this, and then you can see that you only have two terms. So what's the u now? So the u is given by, u prime p and 0, right? So it's x p is 0 and this is 0. So it means that if you differentiate this one, if you differentiate this one, it's back to p, and then you should have u versus you have cn cosine nt, right? So that's why cnt. So that's why you have minus cn sine cnt plus pn cn, this cn, this is for cn, and then the cosine cnt, right? And then you should have sine and nx. So this u t, so this u t x 0, u t x 0 given by is n minus 1, and e n c n sine n x, so this is 0, right? This is 0. So this means that t is 0. That's it, right? Because the sine nx, n is integer, not 0. Right? So that's why all the possibility is bn. If bn is 0. Right? So then eventually, what's your u basically is given by c1, sorry, c1 k, here, right? K, C1, K, all sign, C, T, N1, then minus K, all sign, 2CT, and then multiply by sine, sine has a put in, so there's a sine x here, and then there's a sine 2x here, so this one, sorry, I just rewrite it, where is this, all sine CT, sine x minus k, cosine 2CT, sine 2x, so this is it. So for this question, give this exam, up to here, if everything is correct, up to here, it is 25 marks given 20, and you don't need to break. So it means that up to here is just about the methodological proof to solve this one. And then after this, it's just to integrate. So why I think after you get this step, you will get 20, because after that, these steps are not for this problem. This step actually you should have learned from a previous one. Right? It's just an integration. So sine, cosine, anyway, I will have one question 6. Like this, and so either wave equation or Higgs equation. So I hope this you can enroll. If you get every step correct, you know, up to this stage, I think it should be quite straightforward. Just follow this, right? But this is not the purpose of learning this module. Learning module is good to learn how to solve this one. But if you are really struggling with exam, this is what you can focus on. But I don't suggest you, for example, if you really think you have to do that, so maybe it's what you can do, right? And you can write down this one on your, you know, this E4 size table, whatever. Right? But anyway, 6 questions, you choose 4. But this is one of them. So I cannot see this rather people, so maybe we should write that. You don't need a knowledge learning this model of this one, because you should have learned this by the previous model, right? So that's why I think it's the previous one. So let's stop here today, and then next week I have curve fitting. So after this curve fitting, I will talk about exam question. Next week I will need the most 3 hours of our discussion.
Thank you.